Hello students, welcome to the new lecture, and in this lecture we are going to discuss about few topics. The first one is a fermentation. Okay, so what is meant by fermentation? The fermentation means the breakdown process, breakdown of food material by microorganisms. Let us consider this a glucose solution. So this glucose solution, the bacteria or any fungi, it is going to release some kind of enzymes and it is going to break down the glucose. It means inside the body or outside the body, so such kind of a breakdown is seen. So such kind of process is one of the example for the fermentation. Okay, so example yeast. What the yeast will do? Yeast is going to break down the glucose into alcohol. Okay, glucose into alcohol. In the last experiment also we have seen it is go the glucose is converted into heat energy plus carbon dioxide, and water will be stored inside the body and so on, and plus energy. Okay, so these are the things that will be produced, and alcohol. Okay, alcohol is also produced. Here you can see the yeast. Yeast is going to do the fermentation process. Not only yeast, there are number of microorganisms, they are going to do the process of the fermentation. So depending upon the fermentation, the characteristic smell is produced along with the production of the ethanol. Okay, after the fermentation, if you see the smell of the container, okay, or fermentation process. So during the fermentation process, you will see the characteristic smell. Characteristic smell means different kind of smell. Okay, alcohol has a certain kind of smell, and different smell, which is different compounds which is produced in it, also having the different characteristic smell. So along with the production of the ethanol, what is meant by ethanol? Ethanol is a kind of alcohol. Okay, it will be produced, especially yeast, fermentation of yeast. Some kind of yeast is going to produce the ethanol or alcohol. Okay, and ethanol can be produced from the yeast glucose mixture. So what is meant by yeast glucose mixture? Let us consider this is a container or reactor. So it is going to contain the glucose mixture or glucose solution. In it, the bacteria or yeast is present. It is going to do the fermentation. After the fermentation, you will see the production of the ethanol. Okay, ethanol will be produced, and also it is going to produce carbon dioxide and so on. Different compounds are produced. Here, what are important? We are going to have ethanol. How you can extract ethanol? That is the main question. How do you extract ethanol from the yeast glucose mixture? Yeast glucose mixture means in the container yeast is present and also glucose solution is present. That is known as yeast glucose solution. We have to extract ethanol from it. So how do you extract? We have to heat the container. We have to increase the temperature up to 70 degrees Celsius. If you increase up to 70 degrees Celsius, so the boiling point of the ethanol will be around 70 degrees Celsius. As a result, it will boil off. It will turn into vapor. Ethanol is going to turn into vapor. These vapors are known as ethanol vapors. They are going to come out of the yeast glucose mixture. So these vapors are condensed. Okay, let us consider this is the tube that is carrying the ethanol vapors. Okay, these vapors are cooled down. The temperature is cooled down. So as a result, the vapors are going to turn into liquid. Okay, it is going to turn into liquid. So this is the procedure how we can extract ethanol from the yeast glucose mixture. By boiling or heating up to 70 degrees Celsius, we can separate ethanol from the yeast glucose mixture. Okay, so next one will be the fractional distillation. So fractional distillation means the process of separating fluids from the mixture of solution. Okay, that is known as fractional distillation. So we are going to extract different components from the at a different temperature. Let us consider the solutions like solution A, solution B, solution C is there in a mixture. Okay, so at 50 degrees Celsius, the solution A is going to come out in the form of vapor. At 60, the solution B is going to come out. At 70 degrees Celsius, the solution C is going to come out of the solution. Okay, so it means at the different temperature, different components are boiling and they are coming out as a vapor. So such kind of separating components in a mixture according to the different temperatures, that is known as a fractional distillation. Okay, so fermentation is also a process of energy production, is a process of energy production when there is supply of oxygen. Okay, so it means in the fermentation process, the yeast doesn't require oxygen. No oxygen is required for the yeast for the production of the energy. It means in the fermentation process, the glucose is broken down in the absence of oxygen. It is also anaerobic respiration. Fermentation is an example for the anaerobic respiration. In the last class, we have discussed about the anaerobic respiration. Okay. So the question is, respiration is an energy releasing pathway. Do you agree? Justify your answer. Yes, respiration is energy releasing pathway. So the respiration is an releasing pathway. The statement given is correct. Respiration and combustion. What is respiration and combustion? So both almost similar. So here the Lavoisier in the 18th century came into the opinion that respiration is a process like combustion by performing several experiments. Lavoisier performed several experiments. Okay, based upon his experiment and his observations, he said that respiration is a process of combustion. Okay, so how it will be, we will discuss in coming topics. So not only the Lavoisier, Robinson also stated that respiration is a type of combustion and is the source of heat in animals. If, for example, if you see in your body, 37 degrees Celsius are there. The question is, how 37 degrees Celsius is maintained? So it is due to the respiration. It is due to the cellular respiration. Some amount of energy will be released. Okay. So that it means this temperature is utilized for the maintaining body temperature. Okay. Next one is the activity 2. In the activity 2, we have to observe the changes during the combustion of the sugar. So first of all, we have to arrange the setup. Okay. We have to arrange the apparatus. So here you can see. The strand is there. So the strand. So to the strand, we have attached a test tube, a boiling test tube. In the boiling test tube, there is a solution. The glucose mixture is the glucose crystals are there. Our glucose is present at the bottom of the test tube. So on the top, we have fixed the cork, a rubber cork. To the rubber cork, we have fixed the delivery tube. The main importance of the delivery tube is it is going to carry the gases that is produced in the tube. In the test tube. Now we have to heat with the help of a spirit lamp or Bunsen burner. What will happen? So the sugar solution will absorb energy, heat energy, and it is going to boil off. It is going to burn. The sugar here, which is present in the test tube, is going to burn off and it is going to boil off. Okay. As a result, during this process, more amount of energy is released. It is taking some amount of energy from the lamp, but it is releasing huge amount of energy during the burning process. Okay. So not only the heat energy, but also water will be produced, plus carbon dioxide is produced. Okay. So carbon dioxide is also produced. So these all are the things that will be produced during this process. Okay. And now we have said that the carbon dioxide is produced. This carbon dioxide will travel through the delivery tube and going to mix with lime solution. In the other solution, the delivery tube is inserted into the test tube containing lime solution. As a result, the lime solution plus carbon dioxide is going to give a milky white. Milky white precipitation. So this is a procedure that we can see here. Okay. So based upon the milky white appearance, what you can confirm? You can confirm that carbon dioxide is produced based upon our observation of milky white appearance of the lime solution. Okay. So here the respiration equation also gives the same product. Respiration is slow combustion. Okay, respiration is slow and combustion is fast. So in the combustion, just now we have seen in the experiment, the glucose, all glucose molecules will burn at once. But in case of same glucose molecules in the body, in the respiration process, they will break down slowly. It means slowly the glucose compounds will break down and releasing the energy little by little. So this is the difference between the respiration combustion. So what is combustion? The combustion energy will be released at once. Okay. So in case of respiration, okay, the energy will be released slowly. Okay. Little by little energy will be released. Okay. In case of respiration. Okay. So next. Here the water stops the combustion process in outside. If you pour water in the test tube, burning test tube containing the sugar, so the combustion will stop. But in case of cells, the combustion process occurs in the presence of water, that is known as respiration. Okay, so next, what can you conclude from this? Burning of glucose cannot be stopped easily if once started, but the cells can control the burning of the glucose. In your cells are going to control the burning of the glucose, or they are going to control the breakdown of the glucose as they wish. But you cannot control the burning of the glucose in the test tube or outside the body. Okay, next is the heat production by the living organisms. Here the animals and plants are going to produce the heat energy from the heat, from the burning of the glucose or sugar. In their body, the glucose molecules will be burned, and they, as a result, there is the production of the energy. That energy will be utilized for the different kind of work. Okay, the animals produce the heat constantly to replace the lost heat and also maintain the body temperature. Your body has 37 degrees Celsius all the time. The wind, water, etc., they are going to take away the 37 degrees Celsius. Some amount of heat will be lost, but all the time the 37 degrees Celsius is maintained in your body. How? Because your body is going to break down the glucose molecules constantly. During this breakdown process, the temperature will be released. The temperature will released is going to maintain the 37 degrees Celsius. Okay, so it means they are going to replace the lost heat by the body continuously. During a cellular respiration, excess amount of energy will be released as the heat. Some energy is stored in the form of ATP and some energy will be released. Let us consider this a glucose molecule. During the glycolysis or during the cellular respiration, so energy will be released. Some amount of energy will be maintained for the body heat. Okay, body heat. Some amount of energy will be used for the utilized on the spot. Okay, on the spot the energy will be utilized, and some amount of energy will be stored in the form of ATP. Okay, these are the procedure, these are the things that you can see. Okay, during the exercise, greater amount of heat is generated during the increased rate of respiration. Okay, the muscle starts anaerobic respiration in difficulty of the oxygen, and lactic acid will be accumulated in the body. Okay, so deep breathing helps us to restore the energy in the body. Okay, so here the what are the other ways which body can lose heat? So there are different ways. There are mainly four major ways. Not only four, there are many, but the four are most important. First one is the radiation. Loss of heat from the body to the surroundings, that is known as radiation. From your body directly, the heat will be lost into the environment, that is known as radiation. Okay, next is evaporation. Loss of heat during the sweating condition. So the water which is present on your body, which is came from the sweating, so that sweat will take some amount of heat from your body and it will get evaporated. So as a result, some amount of heat will be lost. Next is the convection. So the burning, the boundary of the heat is present. A boundary of heat is present on the hot bodies, and some agents like water, air, etc., they are going to carry out the heat which is present around your body. So by this way also your body is going to lose heat. Next, the conduction. The loss of heat from the body when cold objects come in contact. For example, if your body has 37 degrees Celsius, if you dip your hand in the cold water, so what will happen? The temperature of the hand will decrease from 37 degrees Celsius to 35 degrees Celsius, and so on. So this is also one of the main way how they are going to lose the heat. Okay, so next is the rate of heat production always the same? No, the rate of heat production is not always the same. Varies depending upon the conditions and environment. Example, we can see during different kind of environmental conditions, heat will be lost. Okay, the rate of heat production will varies from person to person and temperature to temperature and so on. Okay, next, the evolution of gases exchanging system. Okay, the gas exchanging system means what? Okay, how the carbon dioxide is eliminated from the body and how the oxygen is taken into the body, that is known as exchanging of the gases. Okay, so example, diffusion, respiration, and respiratory organs, etc., they all are going to help in the exchanging of the gases. First one is the diffusion. So diffusion is going to occur in some multicellular organisms of the body surface. Example, amoeba, hydra, planarians, etc. In these organisms, you will see that diffusion is going to play a major role for the exchanging of the gases. Okay, let us consider this is the amoeba. Okay, so amoeba, the air, okay, is going to carry out the carbon dioxide. the oxygen will be brought near to the cells, oxygen is taken and carbon dioxide will be eliminated in this way. So this is a example for the diffusion. Diffusion means by simply by water or air, so such kind of waste materials will be carried out. That is known as diffusion. So amoeba, hydra, planarians, etc. are the example. So the special organs developed in some multicellular organisms, especially tracheal respiration, bronchial respiration, cutaneous respiration, buccopharyngeal respiration, pulmonary pharyngeal respiration, etc. So these all are the different types of the specialized developed organs for the respiration process in multicellular. So amoeba is a single cellular, and different kinds of animals like cockroach, elephant, human being, etc. They all are the multicellular. So hence they have the separate developed respiratory organs are present. Okay. So first one is the tracheal respiration. Here in the tracheal respiration, a series of tubes called trachea. They divide into branches called tracheoles. They carry out air into the cells. Okay. Example, the cockroach. In the sides of the cockroach, let us consider these are body sides. Here you can see the small holes like structure. These small hole like structures, they are known as tracheoles. They are going to form a branches known as tracheoles. They are going to help in the exchanging of the gases. Okay. Next is the branchial respiration. In the fishes, you can see the branchial. Okay. You can see the gills. These gills are going to help in the exchanging of the gases. Like they will take oxygen, they will remove the carbon dioxide. So it is a example for the branchial respiration. Okay. So next, the water is drawn into the mouth of the fish when it is opened, and mouth is closed and pushed, and water is pushed into the pharynx and forced through the gills pouches. As a result, the exchanging of the gas is going to take place. You might have seen the fish always opens and closes mouth. What is the reason for opening and closing of mouth? The main thing is water. The water will be taken in. The water will be taken into the mouth, and they will be pushed through the gills. As a result, during this process, the exchanging of the gases will take place. Okay, next, gill lamellae performs gas exchange and so on. So here the gills are going to have so gill lamellae and so on. They are going to perform the gas exchange. So the blood supply to the gills through the capillaries called branchial respiration. Next, cutaneous respiration. The term cutaneous refers to the skin. And the respiration through the skin are called cutaneous respiration, generally seen in amphibians. Example, frog. What is meant by amphibian? Amphibian means that can live in the water. Okay, that can live in the water and also that can live on the land. So such kind of organisms are known as amphibians. So the frog is an amphibian. This frog can take respiration from the skin, and also it can take respiration from the lungs. Okay. So pulmonary and buccopharyngeal respiration. So it is respiration through lungs is known as pulmonary respiration. Pulmonary means lungs, and buccopharyngeal means buccal cavity and pharynx. Both are involved in the respiration process. Hence we can call it as a buccopharyngeal respiration. So in the frog we can see pulmonary respiration, hence the lungs are involved, and we can see the buccopharyngeal respiration, hence the buccal cavity and pharynx are involved. Hence we can call the frog is going to have pulmonary and buccopharyngeal respiration. Okay, next, the pulmonary respiration. It means the respiration through lungs and is known as pulmonary respiration. It means on the land animals like human beings, birds and elephant, horse, etc. They are going to have the lungs. If the respiration is occurring through the lungs, it is known as pulmonary respiration. So commonly, they are going to respire with the lungs. Hence, they have the pulmonary respiration. Okay. And this is about different types of respiration, and I hope this lecture is helpful to you. And if you have any doubts or questions or suggestions, feel free to post in the comment section and we will answer to those questions. Okay. And we will discuss the next topic in the next lecture. Okay.